that.
Oui.
Okay, so welcome to Jacques Torres' apartment.
Nice. So the chocolate business is good for you.
It's good. It's like I'm a little bit like Cinderella. What do we call it? Cinderella.
Cinderella.
You know, yeah. I have the place for what, 20 minutes, 45 minutes, and then it's not mine anymore. So enjoy the buffet because everything going to turn into a pumpkin after that. So. I'm going to show you how to do some little things with chocolates. Actually, this is something that you can all do at home. It's better to do that at someone else's home so you don't have to do the dishes. So it's usually better. So what I did here, I melt some dark chocolates and I temper the dark chocolates. So tempering chocolates means that when you melt the chocolates, all the molecules of fat, the cocoa butter, are aligned together. When you put the chocolates into the refrigerator, the chocolate is going to tighten and shrink from the mold, and it will unmold. That's what makes the chocolate shiny and has a nice snap. But when you melt it, when you pass 90 degrees, those molecules of fat break down. So you have to realign them. So what I did here, I melted and I wait until on the side the chocolate start to be thicker. So that means on the side, those molecules of fat come back together. Then I scrape them, I mix them with the rest, and that's called seeding. You seed the chocolates, all those molecules of fat are aligned. And then using the laser thermometer, this is cool, this is called a laser thermometer. So you click, and that gives you the temperature on the back.
Does that take all the calories out?
Madame,
sure.
The calories are good for you. Look, I lost 56 pounds. Do you believe that?
Wow.
56 pounds. And I still eat chocolate. So the secret is that. Eat chocolate, but that's all you eat. So I was with Jacques Pepin not too long ago, and I was on a diet. And he told me, he said, I have the best diet. I said, yes. He said, yes, you can eat whatever you want, as much as you want, and whenever you want. So I tell him, I say, impossible. Impossible, he said, Jacques, I'm telling you. Yes, you can do that. I say, what diet is that? He say, you eat everything you want, just don't swallow. When you swallow, that's when you get in trouble. So that's his diet. That's his way of losing weight. So I temper the chocolates. As you can see now, the chocolate is ready. It's about 30 degrees Celsius, or about 90 degrees Fahrenheit. So chocolate is ready. I get some latex balloon. So if anyone is allergic to latex, always ask, you know, it's a fair question. Then I'm going to grab in the refrigerator the tray, and I'm going to show you what I do with those balloons. Merci Brittany. Ooh, yeah, Brittany, you didn't see that.
I know.
Okay, so good catch, sir. So you take the balloon and you dip it three times, one, two, and three. And you put it like that. Okay, so far so good. Can you do that at home?
Yes.
I told you it's easy. You see that? One, two, three. Bingo. Okay, so we're going to do six of those balloons. So you know what happened to me one day? I was working, I was doing a show for PBS. And that was when I started to work with balloon years ago. And I usually don't rehearse, but that time, because I never did it, I stay on the afternoon and I rehearse what I'm going to do during the taping. And I did a big balloon, like the one over there. And I piped chocolates around it. So I piped some chocolates around it. But the way I pipe it is using a star tip, not really thinking about it. Piping, piping, piping. The star tip hit the balloon explode. That was chocolates in the ceiling, that was chocolates all over. So I didn't think about that before I'm doing that demo tonight. If that balloon explode, I think I'm fired, no? Okay, we're going to try to not make it fire, okay? Don't make it explode. Yes, I know I'm in trouble.
You don't want to see if I get anything. You don't want to see if I get anything.
Madame, come closer. Let's see what's happened here. Actually, that thing doesn't fit here. Brittany, how do I do that? One. So, first thing that you do, use a bigger bowl. So we're just going to make that like that. That's it. So you can make it as big as you want, but we're going to stop there. That will be enough. Okay, so I'm going to, during the time those balloons crystallize, it's called crystallizing, I'm going to do something else with the rest of the chocolates. I'm going to keep a little bit of these chocolates here. So, when you're done, when you are done with the balloon, keep a little bit of the chocolates, like that, into the bowl, into your bowl. This, we're going to do something else later. I'm going to put that on the microwave behind you. Sorry. This microwave is a little bit like a 747. Into the bowl. Okay. You see, I keep massive shit. Then we go to my crave, then we go to what okay. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to is it working? Yes! So what I'm doing here. I'm going to mix the chocolate with some whipped cream to make a chocolate mousse. So for that, your chocolates need to be over 120 degrees Fahrenheit. They need to be quite hot to the touch. When it's at 120, we're going to mix some cream. Something about cream. I whip this cream by hand. I don't have any KitchenAid here. So what you do, the cream whisk according to how much wire you have in your whisk. When I was in apprenticeship, we only whip cream by hand, but we have those whisks with a lot of wire. So what I understand with that time is if you put two whisks together and you whisk like that, the cream will whip two times faster. That makes sense, no?
Yeah, yeah.
So depending on how much whisk, and now you cannot find those balloon whisk, big balloon whisk, so I put two whisks together. So you want your cream to be soft peak. Uh-oh, make the marbles ready. So, that's enough. I'm scared of this lady. She can't already move all my stuff. Okay, let's see what's happening. Yeah, that's my phone. Okay, so let's see the temperature. So be patient, 1 more minute. We're going to warm that up a little bit more. Okay. Any question about what I'm doing? No? That means I explained very well. Good. Okay. So we're almost there. Brittany, you want to see if the balloon start crystallizing? Who called me?
Dr. Shannon.
Can I tell him a funny story about Dr. Sherman? It's a little bit risque. Can I still do it? Are you? No, you cannot film that.
Okay.
Okay. So, a friend of mine just called me. His name is Dr. Sherman. So, Dr. Sherman is a doctor that fixes feet. He's a well-known doctor. He's a friend of mine. We go fishing together. So, with age, I start to get a little bit of arthritis. So I talked to Dr. Sherman and he told me, take a medicine called Arthrotec. So I take the medicine Arthrotec and I feel a lot better. So I went to the pharmacy and I, next to where I walk, across the street, and I asked the pharmacist, I would like some Arthrotec. And she said, Jack, you don't have any more refill. So I said, oh, that's okay, I know the doctor. So I pick up my phone, I dial his cell, and I give, big mistake, I give the lady behind the counter my phone. So she talked to him, so he ended up, he picked up the phone and he said, Jack! She said, no, this is not Jack, this is a pharmacist. Jack needs a refill on Arthrotec. So he asked, he said, oh, you're the pharmacist. And where is that pharmacist? She said, across the street from her, where he walk. He said, okay, is that people in the pharmacy? So she said, yes, a few people waiting. He said, okay, so you're going to repeat exactly what I'm telling you. Tell Jack that he takes way too much Viagra. I cannot give him any refill because it's bad for his heart. So wait, the lady put down the phone and say, the doctor said that he cannot give you any more. The whole story. So I start to get, of course, you know, embarrassed here. So, oh my God, people know me here. So then she went back on the phone. And he keep talking to her, and he told her, now, you're going to tell Jacques that the extra small condoms that he ordered, this is a special order, not going to take another 10 days. So the lady come back and say, and the doctor said that the extra small condoms, and she tells the whole story one more time. I left the pharmacy with not my medicine. This is a true story. After, yes, he just called me. Can you believe that? My God. So embarrassing.
That's a real New York story.
Yeah, it's a true story, I promise you.
I don't think you can make that up.
No.
That's not really a true story.
Okay, one more minute, then we're going to finish that. Everybody can do it at home, huh? Can you put back the... Am I fire or are you saying bad jokes here? I think even came with that about it. She didn't tell me about those things. Oh my God, I tell her, I always say it. Okay, so do me the honor, just kill those six, just stab them. Okay. And the big one. Okay, you can play.
I wish I wondered how they do that. That's how that works. Very cool.
So you see, that's easy to do some little cups. You can fill them with chocolate mousse, that's what we need to do. Or you can wear them. It's up to you. Okay, so. So what we do here, I warm up the chocolate quite hot. I'm mixing a little bit of the whipped cream in it. So it's called tempering the cream and making the chocolate a little bit less. The concentration of cocoa butter going to be less. And then when it starts to be mixed, well mixed together, we're going to bring everything back to the big bowl here and mix all that together. And then, I'll wash it, don't worry. You don't even look at what I'm doing, you're on the phone. Yeah, right. Ricky, did you take my towel? Yes.
Yes. Oh my God,
that looks good. Thank you. Wow. Okay, so you see the way I mix? You go from the side and you bring it back from the center. So the cream doesn't deflate. Okay, then the mousse is ready. So what we're going to do, we're going to put the mousse into those little espresso cup, and you're going to be able to try it. But because this is a new place, if anyone wants to try some mousse, that was not funny. We're not going to do that.
All the way across.
Okay, so if you have some guests at home, I have to do that?
No.
Okay, so if you have guests, just put the chocolate mousse into the cups, like that. Then, this is dirty now. Okay, that's not good. So use a paring knife. No problem. You see, I don't touch the stuff. Okay. Take a paring knife. Then What you do, you keep the knife as an angle and cut the strawberry this way. You see, I don't go all the way as an angle. I don't damage the marble. Then you put that on top like that. Then take a little bit of the berry. Berry like that. A little bit of the cranberry. A little bit of the raspberry.
Voilà.
And you have a beautiful dessert. Wow. Is that easy to do or what?
Of course.
Voilà. Wow. Now, if you use a bigger bowl than I use, you can dip the balloon a little bit deeper. So now you have a big bowl. Put the rest of the chocolate mousse here, little bit of berry. And when the guests are done with those, they can go into this one. Or you just make one, whatever you like. Okay, so that's the way to make those chocolate balls and decorate them with chocolate mousse. So we are serving some chocolate mousse, but I'm not done yet. But wait. Okay. So, now. Now, I have some chocolate left over here. I have some chocolate left over here. I'm going to warm it up a tiny bit. I'm almost done, but if you don't listen, I don't give you any dessert, so as you want. So what's going on here? I'm going to take some cornflakes that Brittany put somewhere here. So cornflakes and chocolates is a good combination. Cornflakes and dark chocolates. It's good and it's good for you, you know? Exactly. And it's breakfast also. So you just mix the cornflakes. Brittany, where are you going to spoon that if you forget the parchment paper? Huh? Okay, so you just mix those things together like that. And then when it's nice cold, actually we have them over there on the table, we have the same thing. But I'm showing you how to do it. Oh yes, I forget. Guess where you buy the chocolates?
Chocolate.
Jack Torres chocolate, bravo. Thank you.
Really good try too, Kathy.
We can see you in sales.
Kathy, brilliant.
Okay, so then the last thing is, you take a spoon, Brittany, why do you use my spoon? Use a spoon, a piece of parchment paper, and then what we can do is, go ahead, madam. Okay, then you will spoon the cornflakes chocolate into a parchment paper. But really forget the parchment paper, so I do it in piece of plastic here. Same thing.
So this one's really good.
And that's the way to make chocolate covered cornflakes. Chocolate breakfast, yeah, same thing. Okay, so any questions?
Breakfast in the French?
They will set, but in the fridge it will set a little bit faster. But yes, in the fridge then you go in 5 minutes it's done.
Oh,
I have one question.
Anyone want the telephone number of Dr. Sherman? No?